Dear students, in this video, we are going to see the intermolecular forces, or it is also called van der Waal forces and its characteristics. Okay? After watching this video, student will be able to identify intermolecular forces and the characteristics of intermolecular forces. So first we will see what is the intermolecular forces. Before to say the definition, I would like to explain you. Suppose this is one molecule, it is not the atom. This is a one molecule A and this is another molecule B. When the distance between these two molecules, see here, this is the distance between two molecules. When the distance between these two molecules is the less than its molecular diameter, is the less than, means this is the molecular diameter. When the distance between the two molecules is less than molecular diameter, then there is an interaction between these two, and that attractive force, the force of attraction between them is existed when the distance between these two is less than their molecular diameter. That force of attraction we are going to call as the intermolecular force of attraction, or it is also called the van der Waal forces. Okay, is it clear? So let us see the definition. The force of attraction between the molecules situated at a distance less than the molecular diameter are known as intermolecular forces. See here, here is one molecule A, another molecule B, and this is the distance between these two, A and B, which is less than. See, this is their molecular diameter of B, this is the molecular diameter of A, and the distance between these two, this is the C. So which is, suppose if I am going to show it by this capital small b, this small a, this is small b, and distance between is small c. So this c is a less than that a and b, then there is a attraction, force of attraction is existing between them, these two molecules. That force we are going to call as a van der Waal force or intermolecular force. Okay, so intermolecular forces are important for the solids and liquids. These are only important for the solids and liquids. They are weak or absent in case of gaseous substances. Okay, so in gaseous substance, these are the absent. Why they are absent? We are going to see, or you will come to know in the molecular arrangement video. Okay, so remember, intermolecular forces, they are important only for the solids and liquids. Okay, and they are absent or weak in case of gaseous substance. Why it is absent? Because in gaseous, gaseous molecule, they are far apart from each other. Their distance is more than their molecular diameter. So in them, in gaseous substance, this intermolecular force is absent. Now, types of intermolecular forces. See here, there are the three types of intermolecular forces. Okay, first we have seen what is intermolecular forces. Now its types. London forces or dispersion forces. It is also called the dispersion forces. Second is the dipole-dipole interaction or dipole-dipole interactive forces. And third is dipole-induced dipole interaction. Okay, we will explain one by one. So before to that, first we will see the London forces or dispersion forces. So when London force is present, see here, simple, when both the molecules are the non-polar. Suppose here I am having the non-polar molecule. You are knowing all inert gases, they exist as a monoatomic molecule. In the molecule of the inert gases, only one atom is present. That's why we call them as a monoatomic molecule. So this is one atom, one molecule of neon, this is other molecule of neon. Both are the non-polar. Non-polar means there is a no polarity, no positive and negative charges is there. Okay, when these two neon molecules approaches towards the each other, when they are approaching towards the each other, or their distance between is less than their molecular diameter, that time a temporary or instant dipole is developed between these two neutral molecules. Okay, see here, so when the attractive force is developed between the two non-polar molecules. Both are the non-polar, like helium, helium. This is helium, helium. means when both the molecules are nonpolar, that time which type of force is existing? London force or dispersion force is existing. See here, the London or dispersion force is defined as weak intermolecular attractive force due to the formation of temporary and instantaneous dipole in the two adjacent neutral molecule. Nonpolar molecule do not have permanent dipole moment. These are the nonpolar molecule. They don't have the permanent dipole moment because of symmetrical distribution. Okay, in neon 2-8 is the electronic configuration. So in 2 first K shell 2 electrons are there, in L shell there are the 8. They are symmetrically arranged, but when they are approaching towards the each other, when they are coming in contact with the other neon molecule, that time this electron symmetrical distribution of electron get disturbed. Means it, all the electrons, they are coming towards this side, that's why it is going to acquire the negative, and other side there are the less electrons, so it is going to acquire the positive. Similarly, in another molecule also like this, here it is acquiring negative and it is acquiring positive. So negative positive bond is formed between these two fraction, and that is for very, what to say, it is a temporary force of attraction. This is not for the long time. This is for the temporary bond is formed between these two neutral non-polar molecule. And always remember, London force, it is existing between the non-polar molecule. Okay, they don't have the permanent dipole moment. So example, I have given helium, neon in between them. In the beginning, they are having symmetrical distribution. But when they are approaching towards the each other, when their distance is less than their molecular diameter, that symmetrical distribution get disturbed. And electrons are collected towards the one side. That's why it is going to acquire the fractional negative. Other side is going to acquire the fractional positive. So temporary dipole is developed. Temporary dipole is developed. And that negative, positive, this negative and this positive, electrostatic force of attraction is developed. Temporary force is developed, interactive force is developed, and that we are going to call as a London force or dispersion force. So remember, London force is existing between the nonpolar molecule. So see here, I have given here the example of helium. In helium, uneven distribution. In the beginning, it is equal distribution, but when they are approaching, that's why electron get disturbed. So this is acquiring fractional negative, this is fractional positive. In another molecule, this is fractional negative, fractional positive. So here, interactive force, attractive forces are developed between these two, and that we are going to call as a London force. Okay, so London force, it is existed between the nonpolar molecule. See, I have tried to show you the neon molecule. This is the neon nonpolar molecule. When two nonpolar molecules approach towards the each other, here, see here, electrons are less, so positive. More electrons are here, negative, here negative, positive, and negative, positive, there is attraction, and the force is developed. That force we are going to call it as a London force or dispersion force. Okay. Next, second type of force, that is the dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole, name itself indicate. Dipole means those, see here, we will see dipole-dipole interaction force are the attractive forces between the positive end of one polar molecule and negative end of other polar molecule. Means both are the polar molecule. Suppose this is the A B. A molecule and B molecule. This is the fractional negative, fractional positive, fractional negative, fractional positive. So when there is an interaction between the positive end of one molecule and a negative end of other molecule, that time force is developed, attractive force is developed between the two polar. Here dipole-dipole means both the molecules are polar. Remember, in previous case, both the molecules are the non-polar. In London force or dispersion force, both the molecules are non-polar. But in dipole-dipole interaction, both the molecules though are the polar. Okay, so we will see the example. See here, carbon monoxide. In case of carbon monoxide, carbon having fractional positive and oxygen having fractional negative. Other carbon monoxide, fractional positive, fractional negative. Okay, so fractional positive, fractional negative, attractive force is developed between them, and that force we are going to call it as a dipole-dipole interaction. Okay, that we are going to call as a dipole-dipole interaction. So in between these two, one is positive, other is a negative. In between these two, the force of attraction is developed that we are going to call as a dipole-dipole force. Okay, so see here, same positive end, negative end, positive end, negative end. When they are coming together, there is a that type of attraction we are going to call as a dipole-dipole interaction. This we are going to call as a dipole-dipole interaction. Here also you can see. So this dotted line, it represents the dipole-dipole interaction. And dipole-dipole interaction exists between the both the polar molecule. If both the molecules are polar, that time you have to say the dipole-dipole interaction. Now we will see the last type, that is the dipole-induced dipole. Okay. In London, both the non-polar. In dipole-dipole, both the polar. Here, dipole-induced dipole, one molecule is polar and another is the non-polar. One is polar and another is the non-polar. Okay, so we will see the definition. The intermolecular force of attraction between the polar molecule, means that is having the permanent dipole moment, and non-polar molecule is known as dipole-induced dipole interaction. As I said, one is polar and another is non-polar. That time we have to say dipole-induced dipole. Induced dipole means it is generated. Okay, we will see in the example explanation of this. See here, first is the dipole. Means one is the polar molecule. A, it is having fraction. Here is the fractional positive, it is fractional negative. When it approaches towards this non-polar molecule, that time this electron, symmetrical electron distribution get disturbed when it is approaches towards it. Okay, that time it is going to become the fractional positive and it is going to become the fractional negative. Means this molecule, polar molecule, it is going to induce the dipole. Okay, it is not having, it is going to induce, it is going to generate the dipoles in between them. That's why it is called the dipole-induced dipole moment. Okay, dipole-induced dipole moment is developed between the polar and non-polar molecule. Okay, so this is about the dipole-induced dipole moment. Summary, in short, we will see what we have seen in this. London forces of it is existing between the both the non-polar molecule, dipole-dipole interaction between both the polar molecule, and last is polar-induced dipole interaction. It exists between one polar and other non-polar molecule. Okay. Firstly, we will cover the characteristics. So, characteristics of van der Waals forces or intermolecular forces. So, they are weaker than the normal covalent and ionic bond. Remember, they are weakest of all types of bonds. Okay. They have no directional characteristics. Okay. They are not having particular direction. So they are having no directional characteristic. They all are short range forces. Hence, only interaction between nearest particle need to be considered. Van der Waals attraction is greater if molecules are closer. Okay. If their distance is less than their molecular diameter, then and then only van der Waals interactions are possible. Okay. And van der Waals forces are independent of temperature except dipole-dipole interaction. These are the independent of temperature except dipole-dipole. Means if both the molecules are polar, that time we have to consider the temperature. Otherwise, van der Waals forces are the independent of the temperature. Okay. This is all about the van der Waals forces or intermolecular forces of attraction. Thank you.